Good morning, Sandy.
Hi, how are you, Rick?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm fine.
So do you have a question?
My question is about the SEO options in Thesis and what we should be using and turning on and not turning on, and do we need robust meta anymore and that kind of thing.
Okay, you bet. Let's just go ahead and start with that right off the bat here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off your microphone because I hear you. I mean, I hear me through your computer. So, but I'll come back on when I have a question. And if you want to ask something in the meantime, just raise your hand.
Okay.
Okay. So, you know, there's the whole thesis SEO thing starts off with site options, and the first element of thesis SEO shows up in the document head here. And now I never use this, but if you wanted to add something, essentially your site name, to all of your page titles, you could do that right here. So if you selected this and left that little separator, then what would happen is your page title would come first, and then there would be this separator, and then would be your site title. I actually don't think that's I don't think that's good practice, so I don't do that, but you could do that. Then you have your robots meta tags, and the whole purpose for the robots meta tags are sort of one of It's mainly to reduce or eliminate the possibility of duplicate content. So, for example, your no index tag, this is how I have it set up. I don't bother indexing subpages. I only edit, index posts, pages, and category archive pages. Otherwise, I don't index anything else. You can, and that's just because of the way, you know, the organizational structure of my site. I have a site that's very heavily weighted on categories, and if I had categories and tags selected, you know, a given post would be indexed under a category page and then under several tag pages, because each post may have more than one tag. And there's a possibility or a probability of a certain amount of duplicate content. So I just use category pages. And then the nofollow, I do the same thing essentially. I leave the nofollow on for subpages, and I leave the nofollow on for category pages, but I put the nofollow on all the rest. And then obviously the rationale is that all of my content is getting indexed anyway. I don't need to index it by tag and index it by author and index it by page. It's good enough for me to have it indexed by category. No archive. I don't bother with no archive at all. I let them archive whatever page they want to archive, which is actually something good for me. You know, if they archive my page, then it's easier for, if there's some problem with my site, for somebody to see the content. And then the directory tags, I say yes to both of those, and that just gives me more control over what my title tag says. And then again, on this same theme, you have the canonical URLs, and you know, you can, we've got this canonical URL situation where you have, where you can have a page that is, you know, www.mysite.com/mypage, and then it can also just be mysite.com/mypage. And you know, actually with longer URLs, there can be many different potential URLs to get you to the same page. The canonical URL tells everybody what the right URL to use is, and tries to keep all that straight. So I always select on this. And that wraps up the document head. Then you have this homepage SEO, and it's important to understand what homepage SEO is referring to here. This homepage is actually the blog page. And so if you don't have a static front page, you don't actually have a way, besides this, of putting a title tag and a meta description and index information for that page. So if you have a standard blog configuration, this is where you put the title and the meta title in for your main page. So this is a very important spot for somebody who uses WordPress like a normal in a normal blog configuration. If you use WordPress in a page with a static front page, then it's a different story. And this site does use it as a static front page, which then essentially brings us over to the next level in which SEO functions here for WordPress or for Thesis, and that is at the page and post edit screen. And so in this page, for example, this is my home page, and it's a static front page. And if you select edit here, you can see that I can put a custom title tag and a meta description. Now, you know, because this site is just a demonstration site, I don't actually fill this stuff out. What we should really be looking at is my real site. And here we are at my real site. So we'll just go to the back side here, go back to pages. And then, you know, this is my homepage. Anyone can learn how to get their business online effectively. If I select edit that, what you have for on your edit page screen, you have a variety of opportunities to deal with SEO. And the first one is your title. And because of the way Thesis works, Thesis allows you to put a readable page title here that is separate from your Google search title. So this is the page title that people see. Then down here under SEO details and additional style, this is the title that Google sees. So make your own business website. Anyone can learn how to create websites. And then this is your meta description. And so these are absolutely important things for you to fill out. And because this is, well, let's take a look at what the SERP on or search engine results page looks like for this page. If we select the SERP, here's when Google serves up this page, this is what that search engine result looks like. Here is the label or the meta title, make your own business website, anyone can learn how. And then here is the meta description, learn how to make your own business website, so on and so forth. So that's what that SERP looks like. And that SERP is made up of this, and this. Now, the other nice thing about Thesis is it's got this little character counter. And you know, if the search engine only wants to see a maximum of 70 characters, you can see right now I've got 72 characters. If I backspace there, I'm back down to 72 characters. Okay, anyway, it gives us the count of characters. And again, 150 characters is what you should have in the description, and I've got 152. And so as you're typing away, these things tell you how you're doing on the length, and you should try to, you know, take advantage of that. And then the third place to look at SEO is actually in the semantic URL. And I'm going to have to switch to a different page for that purpose, because right now the URL for this page is only byobwebsite.com. But if I come over here to pages and I scroll down here to say edit lesson 6, Now you can see the semantic URL here. So it's byobwebsite.com, video tutorials, start building your website here, and then lesson 6, build your homepage. Now, because of the page that I brought up, I'm showing lesson 6 in this page slug is what it's called. But I could also, because lesson 6 maybe doesn't help somebody recognize where they are or where they want to go when they see the URL, I could easily change this to make it more effective, have a better keyword relationship and that kind of stuff. And so actually that is probably better seen under some of my posts, where if we go to lesson 16, you can see that this is my title, and it normally will take this title and create the slug out of the title, but I didn't really want lesson 16 part 1 in there, and so I just cut that out and made it understanding thesis filters. So now the whole semantic URL, of course, is byobwebsite.com, video tutorials, how to make an e-commerce website, WordPress comments as product reviews, understanding thesis filters. So it's almost like a real sentence. And that's the other sort of on-page SEO tool that Thesis gives you, the ability to edit this permalink. Okay, and so then you have the term tags. And by that, we're talking about category tags and post tags. So if we come over to categories here for a second, and categories, you have the opportunity to add SEO details for each of your category archives as well. So, for example, if we come over here, and I don't do this, so you're not going to see a good example of it, but if I come over to Thesis Forum Answers, which is one of my categories, there's the name, there's the slug, it doesn't have a parent, it gave it a little brief description. I could actually give it a title tag and a meta description. I could decide how I wanted to index the stuff. I could add an introductory headline for the page, and I could add introductory content for the page if I chose. And this is something I should be doing, and I'm going to start working on here in the not-too-distant future, because since I asked Google to index my category archive pages, I should actually put some information here for titles and meta descriptions of those category archive pages. Now, this is something that most themes do not give you the opportunity to do, but it's a element of Thesis 1.8. The same thing is true here for post tags. Post tags are these, you know, tags that you can assign to a post. And again, if we select premium video here for a moment, you can add a title tag and a meta description for the archive page that shows all of the posts that are tagged premium video. You know, I think, actually, and as luck would have it, the same thing is true with custom taxonomies. If you have a custom taxonomy, which I have here called video availability, you can also apply those same SEO details, title tag and meta description, to your custom taxonomy archives. So it's quite a powerful feature. And I think that's pretty much it. Those are the big things that Thesis gives you the ability to do for SEO. And I'm just admitting to you right now that obviously I've not started using this part of Thesis 1.8. Sandy, I'm going to put you back online here and see if you have any follow-up questions. Sandy?
Nope. Yes, I'm here. No, I think you've answered what I needed to know. I get a little confused with the follow and the no follow, and it's a pretty big part of SEO, so I just kind of wanted a little clarification.
Well, you know, the thing to keep in mind with follow and no follow, follow and no follow is whether or not the search engine itself is going to follow links on those pages when it's searching. You know, you've got the nofollow attribute in a link which means that the search engine won't follow that, won't pass from that link onto another one. But the no follow, the follow and the no follow tag for the page itself just applies to all of the links. It doesn't follow any links from that page anywhere else. It just stops.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.